wish they had done better with their UI overall. And also, areas like this. You know, Bethesda could have done so much with the roadside ruins. Instead, they just dumped a single Spriggan in here and a couple of bandits, and they with no notes and no, like, where they came from, what they were doing, nothing. It's like they seem to think that that counts as environmental storytelling. It really doesn't. Let's talk about this area. They could have done so much with this. They could have done so much with the roadside ruins instead of just leaving it as a moss-overgrown ruin that, you know, you don't know if there's like a dungeon below, you don't know like the real history of it. There's nothing that sends you here, and it's like there's a skeleton, there's that Spriggan that we killed just now. But, I mean, there could be so much more underneath this. It's just a one-off, location off the road. There's nothing interesting here. There's nothing that brings you here during a quest line. And it's another example of Bethesda's sheer hubris in ignoring criticism and going, okay, well, you know, our fans have an idea of, you know, what could be sent here. Let's work on that. Instead, they keep updating the game instead of stopping, going, our community is updating the game. Yeah, I know, my character's slowly going to turn into a vampire, but I'm probably going to erase this character and start a new one after I get all my mods reinstalled. But it's not going to be like a heavy load order. It's just going to be some ESL files, a couple of quest mods, story mods, and that's about it. Well, it's funny, is this. Earlier, I had somebody leave a dumb comment on a video of mine. Well, they basically said, "Oh, well, I'm gonna call you a furry, and then I'm going to act like an idiot because I don't know how to communicate with people." Well, that's basically what it was. It's like, "Oh, you don't like the furry fandom? Okay, I don't care. Good for you. You wasted 5 minutes of your life on a dumb comic that doesn't freaking solve anything." I was like, which then got that comment then got deleted. It's like, if that's all you're gonna do is like whine and bitch about a fandom that doesn't really have anything to do with your life, hey, go ahead. Free speech is great and all, but I reserve the right to delete comments on my channel if they're not constructive and if they're fucking stupid. Is that a wolf? Okay, hold on. We have to kill this wolf and take its pelt. After I run into a rock. I'm gonna look for a mod that adds a cure disease spell. Come here. I always end up turning my characters into battle mages. No. There's no healing for you, Mr. Spriggle. I know technically Spriggans are supposed to be female. I think it's funny. Okay. What else is in this area we can go investigate before moving on to the next part? I fought mud crabs tougher than you. Come on. Let's vandalize something. I don't know if we can kill them right away. Dumb chicken. Come here.
I trust you're not planning any trouble. What can I do for you, friend?
What do you think?
You never should have come here.
Took care of her. Now we have to take care of him. Because the one over here, or not. I think they're vampires. We're gonna wait until morning, and then we're going to kill the other one. Oh, great. Thank you. Oh wait, does he not show up? They also could have done so much more with the Civil War. I think the main reason people could criticize Bethesda is that half the talent left after Morrowind, so most of the people that were left to write the so-called quests and stories We're mostly programmers and coders. There are people that had no real accolades when it comes to writing. I am not bothering with the giant herding cows. Get back here. Damn vampires.
Take this and hold on to it. I'll be back for it later. I'll pay you good. Don't lose it.
Slow down and explain yourself.
No time to talk. Snitch or double-cross me and I'll kill you. I mean it.
I doubt that. Right in the back. How much of this did you steal? I think it would have been more interesting for the main quest if you had an option to join, like, the Forsworn. Get back here. Dumb wolf. Let's just, imagine if you could join the Forsworn right out of the gate. Like, you're being sent to Helgen because you're accused of being a Forsworn supporter. and you and when you at- and when the dragon attacks, you can and you escape. There's a Forsworn raiding party waiting outside the gates for you. That they got wind of your capture and they came to rescue you. Like I said earlier, that would require Bethesda to actually be competent in writing. And we all know how that usually ends up. Because I really do think that a lot of the criticisms levied at their version of Fallout and Elder Scrolls, they deserve criticism. The people who go, well, you know, if you're a hater, just, you know, don't say anything. No, that's not how conversations work. That's not how society works. In order to have a functioning society, you need to listen to all sides. Bethesda also has this bad habit with, like, kill loot return, especially, like, when dealing with Supermutants in Fallout 4. It's like, they don't know how to, they really don't, they do not know how to write factions at all. They may come up with a really interesting world for, like, some areas, but they really do need to hire more writers. Certainly try here. I do like the Forsworn bow. Almost could have gotten a kill move on her if I just like waited a second. Yes. I'll send you to your gods. Come here.
Come and face the Forsworn.
Okay. Why just you hit the ground? A really good mod that adds more to the overall setting of Skyrim, especially in regards to like NPCs and stuff. Is Interesting NPCs. It's by the same guy that did Tales from the Commonwealth, Chris Takahashi. I think he did a really great job with it. Okay. Level up. Yeah. We're gonna kill the Hagravens back here, and then I'm going to quit it and reinstall.
Lords of the Wild, life for sworn. Rise from death.
Come on! You can do better than that, can't you? Let me pull this destruction staff out. It's the creepy breathing that gets me. I actually do find that the destruction staffs for the Forsworn are really good. Find this random chest over here with just some random loot, and once in a while you can find a skill book, but not this time. She got shocked by her own trap. That's funny. Barbecue chicken. Yep. We're gonna have barbecue chicken for dinner. Okay, nothing in there. We got the soul gem. We got the bird's nest. Okay. We got a Nordic ruin over there. If you go down that way far enough, you end up hitting a little Forsworn area back in there, and another base over there for Karspire. All right. Link.